Another busy Parliament Day event gets underway, this time at Dunfermline's Glen Pavilion. The presiding officer, the Right Honourable Tricia Marwick, MSP, welcomes a range of local representatives to the evening reception. The presiding officer welcomed by the Provost of Fife Council, Jim Leishman, as well as making her own remarks to open the Parliament Day, which brings Scottish Parliament to local communities. Guests were also treated to a performance by Dunfermline teenage musician Amy Louise Rogers, who had already a connection with the Parliament as she was one of the finalists in Holyrood Rock's contest earlier this year. Monday morning saw the presiding officer and local constituency MSP Cara Hilton at Dunfermline's newest art hub, Fire Station Creative. The venue's founder and creator Ian Moyer showed them round the gallery. They were also given a tour of some of the artist studios on the premises, including a room for art therapy, the studio of silversmith Caroline Finlay, and graphic artist Darren Taylor, storyboard creator for Monsters High and Mike the Knight, and that of upcycler Clara Bella Christie. The next stop was Andrew Carnegie House, home of the three UK Carnegie Trusts, Carnegie UK, Carnegie Dunfermline and Carnegie Trust for the Universities of Scotland. The chair of Carnegie UK, Angus Hogg, and the organisation's staff provided an overview of the work the trusts do and their current areas of interest. Other members of the Scottish Parliament were also in town for the day. The Education Committee met in the City Chambers, and the Cabinet Secretary for Education and Lifelong Learning, Angela Constance, was also in attendance for the Stage 2 proceedings of the Education Bill. Meanwhile, the presiding officer and Cara Hilton MSP continued their engagements with a stop at the offices of the local newspaper, the Dunfermline Press. The final stop of the day was Queen Anne High School, where the presiding officer herself, a Fifer, had been guest of honour at the school prize giving earlier this year. The presiding officer and Mrs. Hilton were greeted by Peter Billington, the school's deputy rector. They met a group of pupils in private session before dropping in with the advanced higher drama class and an art class, rounding off the final Parliament Day of the year and also this parliamentary session.
It's great to bring the Scottish Parliament back to Dunfermline because, of course, the old Scottish Parliament used to meet in Dunfermline and was certainly meeting as long ago as 1200. So it's more a case of bringing the Scottish Parliament back home again.
It's been great to see the community really engage with the Parliament Day, to see hundreds of community groups get involved. And it's been a really fantastic achievement of the presiding officer, and I'm so glad that the local community have supported it.
You can find out more about Scottish Parliament's Parliament Days on our website and keep up to date with the news and events throughout our social media channels.